25th anniversary is brought to you by Manwich. Pull it all together with Manwich.
Welcome back to Feud 25, the Family Feud 25th anniversary. Now back to the countdown of the 25 greatest feud moments. You voted this number 18.
Name something you can't help getting paint on when you're painting the walls of a room.
The floor?
The floor. One actual booty.
Your clothes.
Your clothes.
On your hands. I think my hands get painted.
Would that be a part of yourself, Deborah? Now, this is not a trick question. Would you consider these to be a part of you?
Yes.
Do you see a word like yourself up there?
Okay.
Fine. Good. Do you drive a vehicle, Deborah?
Yes, I do.
Oh, my. Will you give us all a 10-minute start?
Nails!
What? I thought you said nail. Just for a second, I thought you said nail. Did she say nail?
The furniture.
Good girl. Yay! Furniture.
For the Family Feud, introducing the Vallance family. Sal, Carol, Sherry, Tracy, and Valerie, ready for action. And the Curry family. Chris, Eddie, Peter, Kathy, and Peggy. On your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard.
Thank you. The Gene Wood lecture, How to Avoid Taxes and Be a Guest of the Government, will not be seen today. Gene was indicted about 20 minutes ago. You're looking well, Gene. We've got $10,000 to give away. One of the families who wants is called the Vallance family.
Glad to see you, buddy. Thank you.
You've got some nice people here. I'd like to meet them.
I brought the best I could find for you.
You did a good job.
Thank you.
Let me meet everybody.
Okay, this is my daughter-in-law, Carol.
Hi, Carol.
It's my granddaughter, Sherry, granddaughter, Tracy, and my granddaughter, Valerie.
Welcome. Hi. Nice to have you here.
Another one of my two great grandsons.
Where do you live, Carol?
I live in Rosemead.
Rosemead?
South of Pasadena.
Are you retired now?
Yes, sir.
What did you do, sir?
I worked in a bread truck for 42 years.
Who, Helms, the bakery, or somebody like that?
No, I was wholesale.
Oh, were you?
Go to Ventura and back, Whittier and back, over 20 years.
You had a good time.
Good job. Good job.
Do you like being retired?
I love every bit of it. Fishing and playing golf.
Is that what you do?
Yep.
What's your handicap?
Oh, no. We won't go into that.
Oh, all right. Okay.
We won't go into that, Richard.
Okay.
You're sucking me in on something.
No, I don't play golf. I swear to you. I just wonder what it was. My friend Rudy loves to play golf. And that's all golfers talk about.
That's
their
all.
Handicap.
No, it's not handicap.
Have you improved since you retired?
No, I got a bad hip. So
that's good. As long as you've got an excuse. Yeah. Curry's here. Make him feel at home. All right, good. Who you got here, Ken?
The second generation Family Feud for the Curry family.
Okay.
This is my youngest brother, Ed.
Hey, Ed. Hey.
My brother, Peter.
Nice to see you, Peter.
His wife, Kathy.
Hello, Kathy.
And my sister-in-law, Peg, on the end.
Hi, Peg.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you.
So what do you do, Chris?
I'm a student right now in the process of transferring to Cal State University at Northridge with long-range aspirations of law school.
Going to go to law school? That's good.
I hope so. UCLA, I'd like to go there.
Yeah. A lot of very pretty lawyers there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
As a matter of fact, I might take up the bar. Regine, of course, goes to the bar almost every night. If you're ready, we have $10,000.
We are ready.
Come on, let's play. Yeah. 100 people surveyed, top five. Excuse me, sir. He's got all the makings of a lawyer, hasn't he?
He's already.
Exactly. You see where his hand was? It wasn't even the tent syndrome. He was way up there. Flatten it out there, sir. Flatten it out. You're playing a retired man.
Retired.
Exactly. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer, and here's the question. Name something that newlyweds might have their first fight about.
Yes, sir. Honeymoon. Place to go.
Where to go for a honeymoon? Not there. Tell, what would you say, sir?
Sex.
I thought you told me you retired.
I'm not that old.
Oh, you're not that retired. Sir?
Play,
all right. Very good, Cal.
Good.
Hello, love. Welcome.
Hi.
How you doing?
Just fine.
Something that newlyweds might have their first fight about.
Money.
Oh, yeah. Money!
Please, guys.
Welcome.
Thank you.
What would you say?
I would say probably their first fight would be about, like, if they went to an amusement place, what to see first.
Okay. What to see? Not there. Well, it's good. They won't fight about it.
Hi. Hello.
What would you say?
Whether to have children right away or not.
Whether to have children on the honeymoon or not. Not there.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine. How are you?
Who is this?
My lipstick.
Your lipstick? Is
my
it
lipstick,
really?
Yeah.
It's kind of dark, darling.
Not really, isn't it?
No, your lips don't. Look at that. That's brown, like makeup.
Yeah, it is brown.
Jean, come here a second. Come here a second. I just want to test something because it's...
Yeah.
This is Jean Wood, gentleman who'll be in Soledad within a couple of weeks.
Nice to meet you.
I just want a little test here.
Yes.
Just the bottom lip.
Yeah.
No, that's brown.
Mm-hmm.
Now, go like that.
Okay.
Don't keep rubbing it off. I want to see the shade.
Well, that's what I see women do all the time.
Well, I know they do. It's probably expensive. I hold it. Hold it.
Mm-hmm. Good. Yep. Good. Okay. Okay, is it all on?
Did you're
it
right, it is brown.
Yeah.
It looks very nice.
No, no, I'm kidding.
I hate that. Something newlyweds might have their first fight about.
The in-laws.
Okay. Yeah. In-laws? Yeah. You got it. There's two answers up there, pal.
Okay.
What would you think they might have their first fight about?
Drinking.
Oh, dear, oh, dear. If it's there, okay. If not, third strike. Third strike gives you a chance to steal. Curry's drinking. Not now. $78
jobber,
here.
Job.
I think consensus is jobs.
Jobs? They'd have a first fight about the job. Sure, you get the $78. If not, how you get it? Job? Oh. Yeah, I stayed there on my honeymoon. Five? Okay. 78 plays nothing. Let's go. All right, ready? Let's go. 100 people surveyed, top five answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something that cowboys hitch onto their saddle.
A rope.
A rope.
We're
going to play. All right. You're very quick there. Something that cowboys hitch onto their saddle.
A canteen, Richard.
Canteen.
All right.
A canteen. Yeah. Good. Thank you.
How about a saddlebag?
Yeah.
Good
answer. Good answer.
Saddlebag, please. Yeah. Are you all cowgirls? You're doing very well. Pretty balanced.
The rain.
Yeah. Good answer. Yeah.
The rain. Not well.
Oh.
Something the cowboys hitch onto their saddles.
The other end of a horse. With a rope in it. Hook it on and rope it. you know, and put a dally around.
Yeah, but that would be rope up there. Okay. That'd be the same thing, Cal.
I'm sorry.
But don't be sorry. A towel in the saddle here. The other end of the rope. Yeah, something the cowboys hitch on to their saddle.
Well, sometimes they keep their gun belts on their saddles.
All right, let's take a look. Gun belt? It's pretty good there, Cal.
Well, I wore them for 20 years.
You wore a gun belt?
No, yep, horses too.
Did you really?
Yeah. All my kids did. I had one when
they were... Is that why they know these answers?
Yeah.
They're all...
Ex-cowgirls.
Yeah, horsewomen.
That's a better word for it.
Well,
yeah.
Thank you. I'm
much
happy.
Much more dignified.
You're more mature than I am.
Something the cowboys hitch onto their saddle.
How about food of some type?
Food, all righty. Potato chips, something like that. Is there okay if not second strike? You get it all of us there. Food? No, not there. Well,
Richard, I'd like to say a whip.
Say
something
it.
To hit the whip on the horse. A whip?
Whip. I love that word.
Whip is good.
There you got it all. Big lead in the game because you get all the money, Cal. If not, Curry's got a chance to steal. Whip. No. Smart, Chris. $92.
A bedroll.
Bedroll. Bedroll. Sleeping bag. Sleeping bag.
An answer.
Something to sleep on. A bedroll.
An egg roll.
Bed.
Oh, a bedroll. All right. Don't get testy. I used to sleep on noodles a long time ago, and I thought they were onto something. If a bedroll's there, you get the money, if not big lead for you, Cal. Bedroll? You got it. Well done. Well, very testy. $92 there, $78 there. Let's do it. Come on.
Thank
you. There's $10,000 to give to the first family to get to 300. Here we go. At least we'll give you a chance for that money. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name a vegetable you eat cold.
Yeah. Cucumbers.
Cucumbers? 4 answers are beat it, Peter. A vegetable you eat cold.
Carrot.
Carrot?
Yeah. We're going to play, Richard.
We'll play.
Come on,
ready.
Come on,
Gabby. Okay. Hello.
Nice to see you. Aren't you proud of him?
Yes,
Number
very.
One answer. A vegetable you eat cold.
Celery.
Uh-huh.
Good answer.
They are 100 people say celery.
Yeah.
Very good.
Hi.
Pretty Peggy.
Hi.
How you doing? What would you say?
Bell pepper.
There you go.
Bell pepper.
Good answer.
You almost killed your bear when you said that. Bell pepper. You sort of shuddered there. Bell pepper. No, not that. Chris?
How about cold beans?
Cold beans?
Beans.
CB, cold beans. Not there.
Come on, Eddie.
It's clever the way, though, you added the word cold. I like that thinking. Eddie?
I'll say tomatoes.
Eddie said tomatoes. You got it.
Lettuce, Richard.
You say you got it all, if not, first strike. Lettuce! Yeah. 183, play 78. Let's go, Eddie. I hate that music. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name someone in a fairy tale. Could be interesting, yes.
Cinderella.
Cinderella! This is a Here's the complete question. Someone in a fairy tale who has a wooden leg. No, someone in a fairy tale who fell in love. That's it. You're going to play a pass.
Okay, we'll pass, Richard.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And I guess we'll play.
A very strange move.
Hi. I'm warming the carpet.
Oh, that's good. Name a carpet you eat cold. Warming a carpet. Someone in a fairy tale who fell in love.
Snow White.
Good answer. Good answer.
Those two fall in love with the little people? Did she? Was she with Grumpy and Sneezy?
No,
I thought they were
prince.
Just
good friends.
Oh, I'm sorry, the prince. Well, it was some hanky-panky. You cannot be a single girl and have seven guys running around the house. And you know one of them is going to walk into the bathroom. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know you were showering. Snow White!
How about Sleeping Beauty?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Good answer.
It is a good answer.
Thank you.
Kind of crass of you to say it yourself, but it was a good Sleeping Beauty. Oh,
yeah. Come on, ready? I'm going to say Prince Charming.
Good answer. Good answer.
Say it then.
Prince Charming.
Okay. I hate it when people say they're going to say it, and then they don't. For all the money in the right to play for $10,000, Prince Charming!
One loser, one winner.
I want to know why you passed that question.
I don't know either.
I didn't come up with anything.
They told me.
They're not hard, are they? I mean, I would advise no family ever to pass anyway, but they had the big lead, and the danger was...
They had to win the last two.
Exactly. That's exactly what you did.
Yeah.
Well, look, you got 78. We're going to make it $100 so you can all get it.
All right.
Well, at least that's an easy way to
get
it. Huh? Yeah. And we got nice prizes.
Thank you.
Listen, they want to stay here and wish you luck. So,
thank you.
Be very
thank
nice. You. You're all too tired. You can stay here. Okay. Let's go. Come on. Who's first? Okay, Eddie. Eddie and Peter. Going for the money. Right after you. That's good. Oh, God. You guys, it's the last win on the money.
Of grand.
You're watching Feud 25, the Family Feud 25th anniversary. Let's get back to the countdown of the 25 greatest Feud moments. You voted this number 17.
Here's the question we asked the ladies. We said, name something you put on when you want to drive your husband mad with desire.
Absolutely nothing at all.
What would you put on?
No, I think that was... Take a look, Hal.
Come on, you
guys. Nothing.
You voted this moment number 16.
And the first thing you take off after work?
Underwear. I can't believe what I'm doing.
The next question, what time do you get off of work? We'd love you to take the $10,000. Oh. We wish you luck. 15 seconds, please. Name something people get furious at when it doesn't work.
The car.
A specific item of clothing kept in a drawer.
Underwear.
How many years a mattress lasts?
5.
A large vegetable.
Zucchini.
A color on a fish.
Gold.
Very good, Eddie. You're a good player. You started over. You did. You did very well. More specific with underwear? You mean what type of underwear? You're trying to get the kicks here, are you? Type of underwear.
Socks.
All right.
Is that a kind of underwear?
Well,
what else? There's underwear and then there's socks.
Please,
and there's the T-shirt.
No, turn around. Turn around. You asked for it, you got it.
Socks.
Let that be a lesson to you, Howard. Something people get furious at when it doesn't work. You said your brother? What'd you say? A car. That's right, my brother's a car.
Brother, too.
There is it. A specific item of clothing kept in a drawer. The underwear sock.
The underwear sock.
Survey set. How many years a mattress lasts? You said 5 years?
Uh-huh.
Boy, you must, well.
I just
please. I don't even want to get into it. Survey set. Nine. A large vegetable. Taking a tip from Chris's answer, you said a large
zucchini.
Survey said. Color on a fish, and you said gold.
Oh.
Survey said. Okay, let me ask the You are 33 points away from $10,000. Please remind everyone the answers that he gave us. 20 seconds on the clock. Name something people get furious at when it doesn't work.
Car.
Try again.
House.
A specific item of clothing kept in a drawer.
Underwear.
Be more specific.
Socks.
Try again.
T-shirts.
How many years a mattress lasts?
10.
A large vegetable.
Cucumber.
A color on a fish.
White.
Turn around. Something people get furious at when it doesn't work. You said the non-working house, I believe.
Right. Now you know how things
are. Nothing will infuriate me more. Car was number one. Survey set.
Oh.
Well, that's good. It means full employment for houses. Specific item of clothing kept in a drawer. You said a T-shirt? Socks, by the way, and stockings is number one. You need 33 points. Survey said? 4. A little presumptuous, I think, applauding 4.
Yeah, every little bit helps.
Make a note of that, will you? That's quite a little thing. How many years a mattress lasts, you said? 10 years. You need 29 points for the money, and the survey said... The weird gentlemen who are into socks, if you know what I mean, won $10,383.
Air transportation for some contestant and production personnel furnished by Eastern Airlines. The airline which takes you to the beautiful beaches of the Caribbean, Bahamas, Mexico, and Florida. No matter where you're traveling, 121 cities and 17 countries, chances are Eastern's going your way. Some departing contestants receive Aviance. For a touch of tenderness, have an Aviance night. Aviance, a collection of fine fragrance products from Prince Machiavelli. Enhance shampoo and enhance instant conditioner. Moisturize overworked hair. Together, they're designed to leave your hair soft, manageable, and healthy looking. St. Mary's, makers of fine blankets for over 100 years. Blankets and automatic electric blankets for year-round sleeping comfort. The heavy-duty Chamberlain 555 garage door opener with a protector system. The electric eye safety feature sees obstacles and reverses the garage door without making contact from Chamberlain. The Popcorn Now, continuous corn popper from Presto. Uses hot air, not hot oil, to pop corn. Features automatic buttering and continuous popping. Black & Decker's ingenious stowaway step stool. It's lightweight, incredibly strong, and folds to about 1 inch wide, so it's easy to hide the stowaway. Monopoly, Parker Brothers Real Estate Trading Game. A family favorite the world over. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Pass.
Okay, we'll
pass, Richard.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
A very strange move.